So this is going to be a bit of a high risk job, I think, and I really don't have a reason to do this video, but I just want to see why this guy failed. This is from a DELL Area 51 R2 PC, and for whatever reason it's decided not to work anymore. The client said they just moved the PC, not sure if it was plugged in while they moved it, and stopped working. So I replaced it with a new power supply for them, and they're on their way, good to go. But this guy won't turn on. So hopefully we can maybe find out why it doesn't turn on. Now I'm going to put a load on this, so I don't want to try turning it on without any load. So we'll just bring in a hard drive and we'll short the green and the black, so it will automatically turn on when plugged in. So those two, nope, these two. Basically green and black, 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah. When they're in together, it will automatically turn on. And so we'll connect a hard drive. And so this guy doesn't fall, make sure it's nice and secure. Yep. Okay. Okay, so this is the Delta brand. Let's plug in the power. It's plugged in. It's in an on stage. Hopefully no explosions. Okay. Power cable in. See the light of the garage are working sort of, you know, blacked out a little bit, and we don't have any green light there. We're supposed to get green light when status is okay, and we don't have that, so I'm gonna cut the power out. There's definitely power on that cable. Okay. Let's see what's going on. This is a modular, well, highly modular. Even the ATX cable is broken into four. It's crazy. So this will go into recycling, the spare parts, whatever. If we can't get it up and running. If you don't want to open up power supplies, they're very dangerous. They've got capacitors in there, they have charge in them, and I'm also even scared to work on them. These gloves are just for COVID, not for safety. Maybe there's not even anything wrong with this. There is a reset button here. Oh, okay. Maybe that's the problem there. There's a bit of a burn there. Yeah, something's burned there. So that's the issue. That's why it doesn't want to turn on. Interesting. So I want to be able to fix that. And, you know, and then just use this power supply for testing or other purposes. Not for retail and customer. So I don't trust the work I'll be doing there. Okay. So we need to get there somehow, and we want to remove this board out of its position. Okay, so we got ground. Yeah, so somewhere there. It's a bit of a burn mark there. My assumption is just that it could be normal. I'm not sure. We don't know. Delta has been nice to use modular plugs. To make repair easy. As you can see, the AC in just comes out. Most motherboards, they solder it onto the board. Nice. Even here, it's modular. I think, or maybe here on this side, it's a big massive connection here. There we go. The whole thing just comes out. Nice and clean. Okay. Can you believe it? Even this guy here is modular. That's so nice. That's very nice. Okay. I'll be honest, I never worked on such a nice modular power supply before. I did open a lot of crappy brands, and it's crazy to work in those power supplies. You just don't want to touch them, very dangerous. Everything is so close to each other, not something I want to play around with. These are kind of long ones. Mother. Okay. There's a clip there. I think that's holding the motherboard in. There we go, that was good. Beautiful. Okay. One sec. Okay. So what's really happened there? Might have to have a look on the microscope. This massive heatsink. Is in the way. Their Capscom. Is the brand of the capacitor. But what was there? I don't have another power supply like this. From what I can tell, I believe the track is burned. I don't think there was anything there. Probably the track. So, track going one end to the ground, I suspect. Looks like the track is burnt. Maybe there was something there and it's blown. I don't know. So let's give that area a clean and get the alcohol. That is quite a major explosion. Wow. So what you can see there, probably see what I see. This is probably the positive line of the major capacitor here. Maybe that's the ground, I'm not sure. See, the track is gone. And from there to there, the track is gone. I'm wondering if we wire it up, will this explode again? Will the wire explode? Will it be ideal to connect? Kind of scary to work in this area. Should I remove the capacitor just to be safe? That would be ideal. Then I'll have more room. In fact, that's what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to remove these capacitors just to be safe. Okay, let's go. Is the thing working? There we go. Okay. Better be safe than sorry. Far out. Okay. We're going to use the soldering station prize kit that I have a video of demonstrating of using it. Okay. Just so we know how to put these capacitors back later properly, just take some quick photos. Can't be that difficult. Okay, so the tracks are actually burned. Why? So basically these guys here, we're gonna remove them. Need to wait more. Nearly 400 degrees. Nothing yet, still waiting. Not doing anything. Can I up the temperature? Yep, let's go 460. really. Crazy. No, he's not budging at all. I guess this is what you get when you buy a Delta. Top quality. What the hell? Piece of shit. Seriously, what the hell is this? Hey, okay. Must be a joke. Wow. Okay, do you think it will come out now? Far out. Far out. It's not coming out. Scared to heat it up because at high temperatures it will pop. And that's the last thing I want. I can feel it already hot. Oh, wait. Can't even take the capacitor out. I feel stupid. How the hell do I take it out? One technique I could use is put some solder in there, take that all out together. Let's put some flux. Okay. There we go. Nice. He's out, but he's not. Okay. How was it? There we go, fine. That's okay. Okay, let's start on this. Let's do the same process. A lot of interruptions, so quickly get rid of this. So we're gonna put new solder. Should have done this before, I think. And there we go. Just lazy, you know. Okay. Okay, wait. Come on. Come on, nearly there. Okay, we're back. Okay, so this capacitor is nearly coming out. We're gonna do the soldering one more time. Maybe what if I hold the solder there? Ah, there we go. That's a nice technique. Just keep it hot. There we go. There we go. So we got the two capacitors out. That's some crazy capacitors there, aren't they? Capscon, 330 microfarad, 450 watts. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, now maybe we can work on this. Let's go back. So now we've got those big caps out of the way. It's a little bit safer to work. We won't lose our finger or something. All done? Will they come here? So what I'm thinking we do is we run a wire, which may be a bad thing, I'm not sure. Let's change the input. Let's go to the camera microscope. Okay, so we don't have any continuity there. Okay, so let's bring the multimeter, have a look in continuity. Okay, we're in continuity. Look at the quality of this camera, it's amazing. See, there's no continuity. How about here? So if we just fix that continuity problem, I think we're fine. Okay, we'll do that. I wonder if it's touching the ground or not. Where the hell do I find the ground? You can see the burn there, you can see that? Like fire, okay. Okay, I'm looking for something. Let's see if we can find it. Probably not. Where are you? The tool for scraping. I want to run a wire, so I need to scrape that off. Where is the scraping tool? I've reorganized the place a little bit so everything is easy to find. Where the hell is that? Oh, yeah. So these are the wires, okay. Where is the scraping tool? Oh yeah, yeah. Okay, so let's remove this capacitor. Maybe leave it there, okay. Okay. Can I use this tip later, or is this too thick? A little bit too thick. Let me change that in the time being. Okay, here we go. Okay, we got something happening there. Now, how thick of a wire should we run? Ideally, as thick as possible, I think. This is an important power line. Okay. Just because of camera quality. Amazing. I can work off the screen, in fact, but I'm not used to that. Okay. Let's just check continuity there. Okay, so the wiring is there. Now it's just a matter of seeing if it will explode when you put it all back. Okay. Now, to put the capacitors back in. Take a photo to put in the video. Hopefully this is a success. So they just need to go in like this. Hopefully, boom, it doesn't go boom, kaboom. Fucking scared of these things. Okay, one sec. Okay, interruption after interruption. Oh my goodness. Okay, fuck off. Let's get this going. These are very solid, far out. They're like metal, like strong. Nice. But I'm fucking scared to put it in. Well, it's not, there's no electricity, it should be fine. Okay. Wow, even I can't bend it like that. Okay, let's try again. This is going to turn out to be one of those horror stories. Cut him and see Jack. Okay, how do we do this? And the problem is, there is flux solder on these tips, which makes it hard for it to go in. Okay. Oh yes, delivery, thank you. Oh yeah, if you don't mind, just leave it. Oh yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a good day. Thank you. Okay, so I just need to somehow just hold the capacitor just quickly. Yeah, look, you're probably wondering, what the hell am I doing? Yes, what the hell am I doing? This is all just to put a capacitor. Funny comedy show. Fuck. problem is this capacitor. The legs have a lot of solder. It's not going in. And I don't want these too touching while I'm trying to do this. That's better, I think. A little bit more cleaning. Okay, there we go. Just this little help will help it going. Finally, we're getting somewhere. 1 second. Okay. Okay, just see if that's all the way in. Looks like it is, okay. Okay, that's in. Now the second one, the hole is not very clear. Okay. Shit. Okay, let's try that. Where is the other capacitor. Hopefully he will go in properly. Okay. Okay. Okay, we'll have lunch and watch the explosion together. Okay, let's try and put this back together. And see what happens. Hopefully no explosions. And nothing here looks burnt. So this has a special way of going in. Like that. Okay, one word of advice. Maybe do this side first. Okay, so that goes in after, okay. Okay, there we go. Okay, nearly there. What kind of screw have they used there? I think maybe one of these. Right there, one of these, maybe. Okay, that's a crown. That's in. Fan. Okay, let's just double check. Four and four, not sure. Oh yeah, the board. Board is important. One sec. Okay. The most important is what I haven't connected.
Afternoon, sir.
Hello, Santa.
How you going, mate?
Good to meet you.
Thank you. Thank you, the family. All the best.
My pleasure.
See you on Wednesday.
Yep.
Thanks, mate. See ya.
See ya. I love our postman. He has a nice beard. Like all good things, they don't last. Okay, how do we get this guy in? Okay, let's in. Okay, fan will go there. Kind of scared to turn this unit on because that track there got burned for some reason. Too much power, I don't know. So I'm scared to actually power it off. And I shouldn't really power it on. Like I said, this will not be going to any retail clients. It will be just for my testing purposes. There's a unit here. Customers get new units with warranty from the supplier. There's no point risking such stupid things. Just see if that fan spins freely. Yep, no problem. Okay, let's see what mistake we have made. I think one mistake I made, I should tie that cable so it doesn't actually touch the fan, just in case you move the case around, like upside down. One sec. Better be safe than sorry. Thank you. Yeah, the fan should be fine, okay. Fan spin, good, okay. You know, one thing I never checked is my table conductive? No. Because it's a silvery material. Okay. Moment of truth. Okay, what do we got? We got a spaghetti. Spaghetti. So that will give our power to our hard drive. And we don't need that. We want the unit turned on when we plug in the power. Where's the big ATX cord? Not this one. Where's the international colors of Benetton? Here it is. Watts would be nice for a mining machine. Electricity is very expensive here in Australia. I won't be doing mining. Okay. So what we're looking for is green light, fan spin, and this hard drive to be on. Should hear a sound. And we got our black and green. Okay. So safety first, so I haven't got the power cable plugged in, okay. Plug this in. Now. This is not something I would normally do. I've got a fire extinguisher here. It's for... This one is for electrical, okay. So we got an electrical fire extinguisher here. Okay. Let me check if it's working. I'll do it outside one. Yeah, I just did a test outside. Rubbish bin is full of white smoke. So I'll get this ready just in case we have fire or something, I don't know, just to be safe. Okay. Okay, here we go. Yeah, you can see the powder on the floor. Oh, you can't see that? Yeah. Okay, here we go. It's recording, here we go. Worst one I've seen so far is, you know, heating up and then blowing up, but no fire. But I don't know what those wires did, so it may be safety feature, I don't know. Let's see. Cross fingers. Shit. Okay. Here we go. One, two. Okay. One thing I would like to do is first, just don't have this. Yeah. Just have it plugged in. See if you get a light. Just to be safe. Okay. So, light is there. Okay, ready, steady, plug in. Good, no power. I'm happy with that. I'm so scared to touch this unit. Okay. So something else is most likely damaged, and I don't want to go any further and leave it at that for this. But you saw the fault, why this is not working. It's probably other faults in the system. So I've got this multimeter, I can sense if there's power. Look at that. Even though it's unplugged, there's still power in there. It's crazy. That's some crazy shit. Power is out. It's not plugged in. That's why you don't mess with power supplies. It's amazing. Good. Just slowly died out. Okay. So now, let's connect the wire. Where is the wire? Curious to see what will happen. We got fire extinguisher ready. Okay. So it is in a on stage. As you can see, green and the black are shorted. We have a load. Plug this in. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Make sure we got no power. Still some there, far out. Haven't even plugged it in. Fuck. Okay, let's plug it in one more time. Boom. Oh, it's on. Yeah, fan spin. Holy shit. The power supply is on. Jeez. Okay. We'll enjoy a sundae ice cream. See when it will pop. at least if I die, I at least enjoyed a nice Sunday ice cream. Okay, let's cut the power. Power is off. The green light is off. Now, look, we can get another fan. Just want to power up something meaningful. Let me see what we got. Okay, we got a PC here. Yeah, what I don't understand how moving a mother-in-law going mental, then big cleanup. Okay. Okay. Should be fine. Does this have a beep? No. Okay, let's give him a beep. She's here? No. With speaker? Here. Hmm. Okay, we're gonna plug the power. Hopefully no explosion. Okay, ready. Now, plug the power in. Okay. Now we don't have a green light. I'm not sure why. Should there be a green light when it's plugged in? But there is no green light here. That's what concerns me. Okay, I'm gonna press the power button. It should be the power switch. Okay, here we go. Nope. It's on. You heard the beep? Yeah, this power supply is fixed. Okay, let's get the power. One sec. Okay, the system is still on. Press the power button again. Okay, that's off. Okay. Oh, Danisha? Okay, the system just won't turn off. Bloody scared to touch this. Okay. Okay, power off. So one thing I wanted to check, there's no power. This is a stupid test. Just for my brain. So there's actually no short, no ground there. Okay. Yeah, that's all I wanted to check. Ground is ground. Fuck. I was really worried of that. This is weird. I don't know if that makes sense. I've got the one end on the casing. And on black is 0 ohms. On the red is 0.02. Okay, that should be fine here. Okay, 0.18. Okay, 0.21. Okay, as long as it's not a 0 ohms, I'm okay. Okay, that's fine. So this is actually fixed. This is something I will use in my own workshop for projects and whatnot. And if it dies, I know what it died for. So thank you for watching. This has been a great video. I really enjoyed making it. I'll see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.